Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Mr. Marklevitz here again to bring you another lecture video. Today we are finishing our unit on sound by discussing sound mixing and sound editing. Now, sound editing is something that you've actually already done a lot of, okay? Lab 4.1, Lab 4.2, 4.3, all of those labs had to do with sound editing, the recording and creating of sounds to be placed in a film. And the sounds can be realistic, like we see in this example from Spider-Man Far From Home featuring Zendaya.
You know, they used to execute people on this bridge. They would like put them in a basket and they would drown in the water. Sorry.
It's okay.
The footsteps on the bridge, the crickets in the background. I'm not sure if crickets exist in large urban settings like this, but who cares? They're there. Or these sounds can be invented, like we see in the same clip, when this drone thing explodes. I don't know, but here it is. And in each of these examples, again, somebody had to record those sounds, whether they were the crickets or the footsteps or, like I said, inventing this new sci-fi explosion, whatever. Okay, but the point is, all of these sounds were recorded, created, and placed into this final film to give you, the audience, an enjoyable, entertaining experience, okay? And then there's sound mixing, all right? Now, sound mixing is the balancing of multiple audio layers, whether that's your voice track, your sound effects, or the music, into a single soundscape. And your sound mix, of course, can be balanced, like we see in this example from Super Buddies starring Zendaya.
Hey, Strawberry. Hi, Lollipop. Look at you, Rosebud. Your outfit is out of this world fantastic. It just screams girl power.
The dog jumps up on the hay bale. We hear that sound effect. You have this nice music playing in the background. And of course, the dialogue between the dog and the two horses. The horse on the left, of course, is Zendaya.
We gotta neigh it out loud and proud, girlfriend.
Now notice in this example, there's not one particular sound that's dominating over the others, okay? It's all pretty balanced, the dialogue, the music, and even, you know, what little sound effects there are. You can also have sound mixes that change, like we see in this example from Dune featuring Zendaya.
The boy doesn't know our rule. There's no yielding under the Amtal rule. Only death is the test of it.
In this fight scene from Dune, we hear the sound effects of the hits, the characters grunting, we hear the music in the background, the dialogue between characters.
Poe has never killed a man.
And notice how these audio layers are being adjusted. Sometimes the music takes precedent over the voice track and the sound effects. Sometimes the sound effects take precedent over the music and the voice track. And sometimes the voice track takes precedent over the music and the sound effects. Okay, somebody had to do all of this adjusting. It was the sound mixer. And then the music starts to fade. There's Zendaya. And now we're left with nothing but wind. Now, you can also have an audio mix that is purposely unbalanced. Now, I say purposely because I have a hard time believing that any of these multi-million dollar productions would hire an audio mixer who just doesn't know what they're doing, okay? Granted, some audio mixers are probably better than others, but again, these are all professionals, and yeah, I have a hard time believing that any of these productions would have an audio mix that is accidentally bad. But, nevertheless, sometimes an audio mixer might favor certain sounds in order to give the audience a specific, you know, effect or to call attention to a specific sound, like we see in this example from Malcolm and Marie, starring Zendaya.
Do you remember those antidepressants I was on? I'm not on them anymore.
Now notice, she's speaking in that clip, but notice how her voice is buried in that mix, okay? The sound that the mixer really wants you to pay attention to is the knife, because the knife is the threat. The knife is what the audience is reacting to. Let's listen to it again and notice how loud that knife is.
Do you remember those antidepressants I was on? I'm not on them anymore.
Oh, watch out, Malcolm. She's coming for you. And you can also just lose a sound entirely, like we see in this example from The Greatest Showman, starring Zendaya.
That?
Notice how in the beginning of that scene, we hear the music, we hear the audience in the background, and then as Zendaya and Zac Efron have this moment, obviously the camera slows down, but notice how the background sounds completely go away, all right? And all we hear is the music and sort of this slow droning sound effect. They're having a moment, and the sound is reflecting that moment, so you, the audience, go, are they gonna fall in love? I don't know, and I don't know because I never saw this movie. But anyway, moving on. You can also use your audio mix to create perspective, which is something we've already talked about. Let's take a look at this example from Spider-Man Far From Home, featuring Zendaya. Notice how when Spider-Man is far away, the sound of his slinging webs is rather quiet. And then as he gets closer to the camera, the sound effects get louder and louder and louder. Notice that the music does not get louder and louder and louder because that is a non-diegetic sound. That's for us, not for him. It's not part of creating that perspective. And notice in this clip, as Spider-Man moves from the right side of the screen to the left side of the screen, the audio is panned from the right channel to the left channel on your surround sound. That is to give you, the audience, a more realistic sense of being right there with Tom Holland and Zendaya. All right? Your lab assignment for this week? There is no lab, so yay! I want you to move right along to your summative assessment, the scene remake. But we are going to watch a film this week. We are going to watch David Lynch's Eraserhead from 1977, starring Jack Nance, and I think Zendaya's in this. I think she might be the baby, but don't quote me on that. David Lynch, he is the master of sound design, of sound mixing. He has created some horrific and wonderful soundscapes throughout his career. And I'm excited to share this one with you guys. I know it's a little bit weird, but it's a fun one. So I hope you enjoy it. Anyway, email me if you have any questions or talk to me in class. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye.